Keeper, having a little holiday fun. Why else would I be in this getup? Unless there was a clause in my contract. In fact, I've got some Christmas goose for you. Goosebumps, that is. Yes, indeedy. A little terror tale chock full of holiday fear. I mean, cheer, of course. So, get a gander of a yuletide yelp yarn that goes a little something like this. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
God bless us, everyone. Right.
Something needs to be done about that fire. Have you got the poker?
Yes.
Well, let me have it.
What did you say?
What are you, deaf? I said let me have it.
Merry Christmas, you son of a bitch.
In bed, young lady.
But he's here. I saw him.
Who?
Santa Claus.
Oh, come on now.
But I saw him. He was outside. Good night, Joseph.
Oh, come on now.
How come Joseph didn't say good night to me?
He's asleep, sweetheart, like you're supposed to be.
But when Santa comes, he'll wake Joseph up.
Honey, I don't think even Santa could wake up your stepfather. Now, you get to sleep, young lady, or the big guy won't come at all.
I can't sleep. It's too hot. See, you're even sweating.
Well, I'll tell you what, then. I'm gonna open this window for you, but just a little bit, okay? The one thing you didn't ask for Christmas, young lady, was a cold.
What did you want for Christmas, Mommy?
I already got it, sweetheart. I already got it.
Hey, it's the Big Monster. I'm out partying. Leave your name, number, and measurements.
Darling, it's Elizabeth. I know you told me not to call, but I just had to tell you. It's done. I did it. It's all ours. The money, everything. We're free. Merry Christmas, darling. How many times have I asked you to lose some weight?
Christmas Eve after KEC News on the hour. And now here's Tracy Donahue with the headlines.
Police and sheriff's departments in the Gaines County area have issued an all-points bulletin this evening for a male Caucasian reported to have brutally murdered four women in the Pleasantville area. County authorities say that the man, a patient at the Pleasantville Institute for the Criminally Insane, escaped earlier this evening and should be considered extremely dangerous. Officials confirm that the suspect is a heavyset man in his late 40s and is reported to be wearing a Santa Claus suit stolen from the home of one of his victims. All citizens in the Pleasantville Gaines area are advised to remain in their homes until further notice throughout this emergency alert situation.
A few sit-ups. Trip to the gym. Once in a while, it wouldn't have killed you. How about a nice cold plunge, Joseph? Now you're dead. Who's there? Hello?
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Mrs. Kamen?
Yes?
Mrs. Kamen, this is Sergeant Feldstein at the Pleasantville Police Station. We're calling everyone in your immediate vicinity about the individual who escaped from the mental hospital tonight.
Huh?
Have you heard anything about it on the news or...
No!
Well, ma'am, he's killed a couple of people. We have reports he's wearing an old Santa Claus suit, and we're sending deputies to all the homes in your area just to check up.
You're sending the police here?
Yes, ma'am.
Here?
That's right, ma'am. There should be a man in your area in about 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Well, is there anything else I should know about this individual?
Well, not really, ma'am. He's apparently used an axe to kill his victims. I don't mean to alarm you, but, well, for your protection, we do suggest you lock your home and remain indoors until the deputy arrives.
Yes. Oh, I will. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Don't panic. Don't panic. Don't panic. Oh, no, officer. I didn't kill him. Santa did it. Didn't you, Santa? Didn't you?
Operator.
The killer! The killer is here! Please, get me the police! I knocked him out! He's here! You've got to hurry!
He's there?
Yes! Yes, he killed my husband!
Give me your location.
My location?
Hello? Hello? Ma'am?
Old Crypt Keeper checking out one of his ghoulie magazines. Which gives you a little hint about tonight's bedtime story. It's all about the way some guys just die over a pretty girl. But don't worry, kiddies. If it starts to reek a little of rotten romance, I think the title of our nasty narrative makes no bones about where its heart is really at. I call it The Thing from the Grave.
Bruckner? Bruckner, where is she? Answer me, goddammit, is she all right?
Yeah, she's just fine. I wish I could say the same for you, big guy. Oh. Tell me something, is that the shoulder she used to cry on? Or was it the other one? Oh! Where you going? Hi.
Oh.
I'm sorry there's no headstone. Ten Commandments were carved in stone. You remember the Ten Commandments, don't you? Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife was part of the deal.
She's not your wife.
Well, she will be pretty soon. Why don't you get your ass in there?
What happened to thou shalt not kill?
Fuck it. I want you to remember one thing before you go to hell, you miserable piece of shit. Remember, she's mine. Not yours. She's mine.
Yeah, good, 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 good. Uh-huh, one more. All right, and everyone take their first positions, please.
Okay, great. My God, this is cheesy.
I wasn't gonna say anything.
Definitely a high cheese factor.
It's that guy.
Well, I tell you what, they love him in Japan. Okay, now, isn't this better than being on an authentic tropical island getting all hot and sweaty?
I don't know, sometimes I like getting all hot and sweaty.
Hey, boss, why don't I hold the can in my other hand? I mean, like, my character is, you know, hanging with these babes and stuff, so I was just thinking, party down.
Party down, absolutely. Knock yourself out, pal.
Excuse us.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Well, he's a real brain surgeon. How the hell do you deal with a guy like that?
Hey, what, it beats working for a living. Okay, Maria. There you go.
God, she's hot, isn't she?
And who might you be, by the way?
Mitch Bruckner. I'm Stacy's manager.
Uh-huh.
I'm also her fiancé.
Stacy, why don't you give us a little three-quarter turn, a little taste of Bud, you know?
Okay.
Spice it up.
Listen,
looking good.
Mike, Butch.
Mitch.
Mitch. Stacy wants to make you really proud of her. Isn't that right?
Right.
Okay, and we're under just a little bit of a time pressure right here.
Right.
So go out and you get yourself a little bit of coffee, okay?
Are you suggesting that I'm making Stacy nervous?
No.
Because I'm not making her nervous, you understand? If anybody's making her nervous, I think it's you. Because you're hitting on her every 2 seconds, you understand what I'm saying? I got an idea. Why don't you take this nice long lens of yours, get it nice and covered with Vaseline, and shove it up your fucking ass! Get some shots to the inside of your asshole, hot shot.
I love that guy. All right, let's lose the lights and everybody take 10.
Wow, that dude is a bummer.
Yeah, boy. Thanks for the input. That's a swell boyfriend you got there.
I'm really sorry.
No. Look, it doesn't matter.
He can really be sweet sometimes. I think things just haven't been going well for him lately.
Really? With you to come home to? I don't know. So, listen, I know that it's none of my business, but can I ask you a personal question? He seems like, I don't know, like he's a bomb, you know, just waiting to go off. Does he ever get rough? If he did, and I'm not saying that he's going to, right? But if he did, and you needed some place to come to kind of cool out, this is key to my studio. And what I have here is I have an extra bed, and I have a television set, and I have a refrigerator over there.
Not interrupting anything, am I?
I guess it was pretty forward of me to give you that key, huh?
I guess it was kind of forward of me to use it.
Well, as long as we're being so goddamn forward. Look, I have something I'd like to give to you. An old blind lady gave this to me. She said that it was the Mayan god of truth. And if you make a promise while you're holding it, no matter what, you're gonna keep that promise. It's corny, isn't it?
Look, it's over with him, okay? I had some hard times and he was there. I guess that's why I stayed so long. I owe him.
Wait a minute, don't you think that you're paid up, Stace? Come on, this asshole has been using you.
I know.
Okay. Well, if you know that, then why don't you tell him?
I'm afraid. I don't know what he'll do.
Listen to me. You don't have to be afraid anymore. Whatever happens, I'll be there, right? I'll protect you. I promise.
reach Devlin Cade's stations, please leave a message. Thank you.
Hello.
Cates.
Yeah.
This is Bruckner. Look, I know everything, all right? Don't ask me how. It's not important. What is important is that she's in trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Shut up, okay? We had a fight. She went to our cabin. Look, she doesn't want to see my face. She won't accept my help. But maybe she'll listen to you.
Where is she?
Get a pen. All right, you'll need to take Highway 5 about 30 miles. Again? So what's the deal? You've been trying him for a week.
What are you talking about?
Come on, Stacy. I'm no genius, but I'm not blind. Think I didn't see the way you guys looked at each other at that shoot? Then there was that night you said you went out with your girlfriends.
You followed me? You are such an asshole.
No, actually, I didn't. I really didn't know. But I'm not wrong, am I?
Huh? What do you want me to say?
Look, I know that things haven't been too good between us for a long time. I've been stupid and I've done a lot of bad things. Sometimes I get frustrated and I don't have the words and I use other things, and that's wrong. I know that. I also know that whatever we had is probably gone or changed anyway. And it's my fault. I fucked up. You're the best thing that ever happened to me, Stacy, you know? And I love you very much. It's probably a little late for that. You need to move on, and you deserve it. I need to ask you one thing. If this guy loves you so much, why hasn't he called by now?
Something's wrong. Maybe something happened.
Just think about it for a second. This guy meets beautiful girls like you every day. They're nothing but 8x10s to him.
But he said things.
Well, welcome to the real world. You know, a guy would say anything to get into your pants. Just, why hasn't he called you for 6 days?
Why do you think I'm worried?
What, do you think he's a corpse somewhere?
I don't know. Maybe he had an accident.
Yeah. Or maybe he flew off to Paris with some 19-year-old Eileen Ford discovery. Don't you see what I'm trying to say? I ain't Pat Boone, all right? But I'm here for you.
What if you're wrong?
If I'm wrong, then I let you go. You do what you gotta do. But if I'm right, I think you owe it to yourself to at least think about giving us another try. I love you so much, Stacy. Just promise me you'll forget about him.
Devlin? Hello? Thank you.
gosh. Look, I'm sorry it had to end up like this. I really am. You know, if you just left well enough alone, everything would have been fine. Goes to show, you start to care about somebody, everything goes to hell. But hey, just because it's over doesn't mean we can't have a little fun first. I should warn you, there really isn't any point in calling on your sweetheart, because Romeo isn't going to save you this time. Do you want to know why? Well, it's because I buried him in the woods outside. That's why. No! Yep, he's dead, and he's buried, and he's rotting in the fucking ground right now. No, go ahead, cry your eyes out. Makes you happy. So you can just stop dreaming about him coming to save your pretty little ass, because it ain't gonna happen. Okay?
To assume the position, if you know what I mean.
and prepare for another assault and battery on your senses. Tonight's Seamy Saga is about a nice young man with a very bad attitude. In fact, it's positively criminal. I call this little game of chops and clobbers Carrion Death.
Move, bitch! Out of the way!
This program with an update on the manhunt for Earl Raymond Diggs, who escaped Yuma Prison just hours before his scheduled execution for the brutal murders of three Phoenix nursing students. Diggs apparently feigned illness during the night, and when the prison doctor was called, seized him as a hostage. Diggs killed both the doctor and a prison guard before escaping in the doctor's late model Cadillac. State and local police in five counties have been alerted to be on the lookout for Diggs, who is believed to be headed for the Mexican border. Diggs is described as 5'11", dark hair and blue eyes. He is armed and extremely dangerous.
And very rich.
Let's be careful out there, folks. Now let's return to our regular schedule program.
Shit.
Son of a bitch is on my tail.
Ten-4, asshole. Over and out.
Save this mess. Falling off. Yeah. Okay. All right. This is west. These mountains must be.
Mess goes right over that hill. Sorry, Bertie. This buffet's been canceled. But there's civil servant lunch over that hill.
Diggs took off on foot. All right. But just remember. I saw him first. Your heart out, you goddamn scavenger. You're not eating me. I'm too tough to digest. Freeze! What's this, Diggs? A bribe? Diggs! I know you can hear me! I will take you down! I'm taking every one of those dead presidents out of your hide. For me to drop, aren't you? Why didn't you go after that cop when he was flat on his back, huh? Made my life a lot easier. No. Guess you're chicken, Vulture. I better keep my eye on you. What the fuck is that?
Only 2 miles to Joe's border.
2 miles? Damn! Nice cold beer. Señoritas. Maybe even a taco. Yes, yes, huh? Waitress, 2 beers.
Which way'd you go, Diggs? Which way'd you really go?
You trying to tell me something, Lassie?
Thanks, partner. Okay. hope you enjoy your meal, Diggs. Because it's gonna be your last. Executioners waiting.
Shit! No water, no food, no bullets, nothing to get these fucking handcuffs off! I didn't bust out of death row to end up like this. You again! You know, you're really starting to piss me off! Huh, where's that gun? Huh. Coming up, one dead vulture.
Walking to Mexico.
Oh, yeah. Not a problem. This is gonna be a walk in the park.
Grab that for me, will
you? Oh, boy. Mexico's gonna be great. Are you speaking Spanish?
Oh, that's right. I forgot. You don't speak at all.
And you know what's worse? And the goddamn lawyers, and the goddamn judges. It's the fucking newspapers, man. They try me in the press. They call me a sick, perverted sadist. That's just total bullshit. I didn't mutilate a single one of those girls until after they were already dead. Of course, if they knew about the five I killed in Kansas, I'd still be on trial. Women. Can't live with them. Can't fit more than one in a trunk at a time. How much you weigh, anyway? A lot heavier than you look. Come on, Dixie! Get motivated! That's right. 83 more and 60.
Ideas?
No, I didn't think so.
Almost there.
I can't believe it. We're almost there. Just about. Hey! Wanna dance? Come on. And we're off. I beat you. 5 more minutes, you're gonna have to extradite me. Come on, Dixie, let's get him.
Boy, you're really getting stiff.
Come on. You can do it. Oh, you're doing great. Come on now. Oh, that's right. Almost got it. Come on. Just almost there on the top of the hill. God, I'm proud of you.
You lost, Vulture! I'm getting away!
Okay. Here.
Hold this for me, will you? Thanks. Come on. Come on. That's your little dance, huh? Come on. All right.
Jeez, it's gonna hurt.
Genius, DC. Ooh, this baby's gonna cut fine. All right. It's been nice traveling with you, cop. But this is where we go our separate ways. Believe me, this is gonna hurt you more than it hurts me. Hang on, Dixie. Don't black out on me now. All right. One, two, three. Fuck! Oh my God! Fuck!
Diggs. Here today, leftovers tomorrow. Boy, talk about flipping someone the bird. Personally, I'm with the buzzards. Except I like my meat a little more well done. Cook 'em, Dano! You're just in time. I'm trying out a few recipes for my new Betty Croker cookbook. I hope you like shish kebab. Damn, it isn't ready yet. Bob's still moving. Tonight's fowl feast will begin with mashed potatoes, then move on to some shrieking duck, and finish with a nice kielbasa. I call this tasty tidbit Mournin Mess.
made some fresh bed sheets. Evening edition.
Yep, look at that.
Oh, fuck the hooch, man. I'm taking you to a hospital.
All right, fucking hospital. I got too many good rounds left in me yet.
Fucking cancer, you're going down for the count. I'm going for help.
Who's out there? Listen here, I'm a former middleweight.
Fuck it, stop.
Dancer.
Shit, dancer! Dancer!
You gotta leave now.
I thought we were gonna spend the day together.
Well, that was Jack Danner's talking. Dale Sweeney's telling you to cop a broom.
What?
Oh, shit!
You think you can just chew women up at night and spit them out in the morning?
Baby, in my line of work, you don't have time for long meals.
Me. You make me sick!
You motherfucker! Fuck oh, you! Jesus. You should be living in a motor home that you have no class, you idiot!
None of the problems which plague our society can be fully overcome without the cooperation of private enterprise. I and six of my fellow citizens are here today, not simply because we believe that statement, but also because we share a common past. We were all once homeless, and are homeless no longer. We feel it is time to repay our city for providing us with the opportunity to help ourselves. Therefore, we have banded together to form the Grateful Homeless Outcasts and Unwanted's Layaway Society. The Grateful Homeless Society, for short.
You're late again. I guess the great Dale Sweeney really has lost his touch.
I could lose my eyesight and still run circles around you, Clint.
You forget who broke the insurance scandal last month? Friends are starting to call me.
Friends? I didn't know your friends could read.
Hey, Mr. Sweeney, your tears are numbered, and I'm on your ass.
Stay on your own ass for a while, Putz.
Hey!
So after a lifetime of pain, there will be an eternity of dignity. Now, in keeping with my usual demure nature, I will defer all questions to our society's spokesperson, Ms. Jess Gilchrist.
Excuse me, Ms. Gilchrist?
Thank you, Mr. Gilchrist.
Shouldn't you be spending money above the ground instead of underneath it?
We don't think so.
And why throw money at the dead when you can use it to help the homeless who are living?
That's a good point.
The Grateful Homeless Society feels that there are many existing organizations that currently provide aid to the living. Beacons in the Night, as Mr. Copard liked to...
It's safe to say that there aren't enough of these beacons to keep you from opening up this place.
That is your interpretation of the situation. Yes.
How many members of the society have, anyway?
Oh.
I only wish that you could be the first recipient of the Grateful Homeless Society's generosity.
They cut my electricity. My alarm did not go off.
Well, maybe you should buy an alcohol-powered generator. That way you could urinate into it every morning and have enough electricity for the whole day.
That's hilarious. Give me a break, Tillman.
No, break isn't exactly the term, Mr. Sweeney. Try severance.
Severance?
Yes. I'm not going to play this crap game with you anymore. Will Sweeney show up, or is he too busy getting his oil changed?
Please, don't do this to me now, please.
All right. How about 5 seconds from now?
Elaine, I mean, come on.
Time's up. You're fired.
Okay, fine. There's no skin off my nose. I'll just go hit up the Herald.
Great. You want a recommendation? I mean, it's a great chance to cripple the competition.
Makes the street look like the fucking White House.
Look, man, I got nothing to give you, man.
You got fingers, you got a hand.
What's the matter? Don't you recognize the homeless killer?
Shit.
I need you to use those fingers and those hands of yours to do a little ink slinging for me. I need you to write an article.
What about?
I ain't no killer. The only thing I am is hot up.
If you're not the killer, then who is?
If I told you what's going on, you'd think I had a kink in my slinky. Tomorrow, they're having their first planting at the Grateful Homeless Cemetery.
Cemetery?
Go there. Hang out till sunset. You'll see. Do it, and I'll spill the rest like a fucking floodgate. I'll even throw in a few names.
Names?
Yeah. City officials with their mitts in the Grateful Homeless. Meet me tomorrow night, 25th in Tivoli.
Wait a minute. Why me?
Because you look hungrier than I do.
Time to keep and a time to cast away. Time to rend and a time to sow. Time to keep silence and a time to speak.
That's home now.
The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away.
Sometimes he forgets that first part.
That's a pretty jaded view of life.
Well, maybe coming from you. I mean, the Lord giveth you plenty.
You've taken quite an interest in this place.
I'm just following up a story, looking for anything out of the ordinary.
Well, there's nothing here but the dead. Why not let them rest in peace?
And dignity.
That too.
Hey, look, I hope I didn't rattle you too much the other day.
It takes a lot more than that to rattle me.
Oh, well, I would give anything to find out just what that could be.
Well, stick around. You're working up to it.
I was kind of hoping to buy you lunch.
Now, why would I want to have lunch with you?
Because I'm far more interesting than whatever Gumby might be seeing right now, and you also might be interested to see the story that I'm writing on that little society of yours. What do you say? Huh? Love telling stories. Ugh.
You know, I was thinking more along the lines of a nice, quiet restaurant.
Well, this is quiet, and you don't have to leave a tip.
At least not money. So, I thought you were going to tell me a story.
Well, actually, I thought it would be better if we waited until we finished eating.
Why is that?
I lied. It's just a routine notice. Needed the company. You're not gonna storm out of here?
You've already killed my afternoon. Besides, it never hurts to improve press relations.
You know, the Grateful Homeless Society is very fortunate to have you for its spokesperson.
Uh-oh. Are we working up to a compliment?
No, it's just that most spokespersons don't have a sense of humor, nor do they look like you.
Now I am rattled.
Sure you don't want to bite?
I don't eat meat.
Oh, God, you're not one of those, are you?
Not exactly. You look good enough to eat.
I've never met anybody like you, boy. You wear me out.
Do you really want to see me again?
Yes, I really would like that. You know, I'm not the type of guy who believes in love at first sight, but I think I'm about to convert. You're the type of girl that I could spend a lifetime with. Hey, let me ask you something. Off the record. What do you think about the Grateful Homeless Society?
Who cares? Off the record.
Wait.
Is this your own private press conference? Is that what this is?
Okay, just go easy with that, will you?
I've just declared a news blackout.
Well, look, you know, I'm only doing my job.
You don't want to see me do mine. So, I'm the kind of girl that you could spend a lifetime with.
All right, just pumping you for information. No doubt. Where that came from.
Roebuck!
I saw was graves. Who the hell did this to you?
You fucking dickhead. You didn't stay long enough.
You're gonna tell me your story. Huh? You're gonna tell me what you know. Names! You were gonna give me names! I need that fucking story, you fucking bum! Don't die on me! Don't fucking die! Oh, come on, you son of a bitch! need help.
Help? Mr. Sweeney, you need burial.
I need an assignment, Tillman.
You must be joking. I'm gonna have to hire somebody to come in and clean up the mess you made just walking in here.
You wanted to see me, Chief?
Wait a minute, wait. You gave my job to this lowlife?
Yeah. I thought it was about time I had a writer doing it. I want you to head out to the Grateful Homeless Cemetery. They're burying that homeless killer there.
Today?
That's right. You better hurry if you want a spot. Now look, I don't want to have to call security. What am I saying? I'd love to call security. Norma, get security up here. Never mind, Norma. Just call a janitor.
And so we commit this soul to eternity.
Bastard was right. Thank you.
Good evening, Mr. Sweeney. Nice of you to drop by for dinner.
Who the hell are you people?
Well, that depends. Until recently, we were known as the infamous homeless killer. But now you may refer to us as the grateful homeless outcasts and unwanted layaway society.
Ghouls?
It's been so long since we've had fresh meat.
Me, sweetie. I just stopped in for a scoop. I'm not really hungry. I'll just pick.
You say? I guess in the end, Mr. Sweeney learned not to go digging into other people's business. Although you'll be happy to hear he's found himself a new career. As a ghostwriter. So, still hungry for dessert? I hope you like cannibal soup. It's good.